I was writing with my friend Wayne Rodriguez, and in his studio there's just walls of records. Each wall, it's just records from floor to ceiling. So, you know, you're in there and you start pulling out records like, ooh, look at that. Hey, let's listen to that. And of course, that one is right next to, you know, another cool one. So, you know, I'm taking down old Ramsey Lewis records and Junior Walker records and, you know, Archie Bell and the Drells. And, you know, before you know it, we're just sitting there at the record player playing all this stuff with stacks of records up. They're everywhere. And we've got so much inspiration for this new record. You know, it's all just musicians playing in the same room, great old horn bands, or just a great vibe. All of those records that we were pulling down, you know, they all were from kind of 60s, 70s, but they all just felt great. It just felt like you were in the room with them and that you were at this party somehow, that you were just into it. So I really thought to myself, that's the direction I want to go with this. Let's see what comes out, let's write, but I want that vibe, I want that party. Oh, oh. Yeah, 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 yeah. My band is a bunch of great guys, and I have to say, over the years, we've become such a family. My drummer, Jamie Tate, and I grew up together. His dad was a guitar player, and my dad was a sax player, and I grew up on the road with their band. It was called The Entertainers. So Jamie and I are second generation, which I think is the coolest thing in the world. And we've actually gotten our dads to come up and sit in with us when they're in the same town, and you know, it was pretty amazing.
This is a man's world. This is a man's world.
But it was. I always sing on my records. I've sang on every one since my first one for Verve. And I always kind of choose what songs to sing, whether I write lyrics for them or not. And so that's always kind of been, oh, if I write lyrics, I'll sing this one. Or, you know, this one seems to me to be more of a soprano song, or this one has a little more power, a little more guts, I'm gonna play it on alto. So to me, they're all kind of different instruments and different colors, different personalities that you can add to a song. I also had my friend Layla Hathaway. We went to college together. And, you know, back then we were just kind of finding ourselves musically, listening to music, figuring out what we liked, you know, doing recitals together. And I just remember, even back in college, I'd be standing there on stage with her and I just thought, she's special. She's just special. And I thought, you know, this is so crazy. I called her up. I said, what would you think of doing It's a Man's, Man's, Man's World? And she, little silence there on the phone, she goes, well, I think it'd be pretty cool. But we'd have to do it as a duet, you know? She goes, I don't want to sing the song and have you come in for the sax solo. It's so done, you know? Everyone's done that. So let's do it as a duet. So, all right. So we sat in the studio and we kind of, okay, how should we do this? You know, went back and forth on form, and it was incredible. It was just incredible to be in the studio with her. I think so much of her talent, and, you know, to have us be friends and have that bond, but also musically to be such a fan. There's a lot of love in that track. It's very cool.